So a few words about the reform project. It became clear that the pressures on lakes and rivers in Europe are not only caused by water quality, but that there's also a big problem with hydromorphology, that and then with rivers and streams, that they are regulated. So there was the European Commission prepares calls for research projects. So there was a call 5 years ago to draft a research project on the on the consequences of hydromorphology, and at the same time how that can be mitigated or partly reversed by restoration projects. Here you see an example. You probably all like olive oil on your salad. And this is what is happening in the south of Spain. If you go actually to Google Maps and you zoom in to the south of Spain, you see a yellow layer and you see very regular green dots on it. And each green dot is an olive tree. And they use a lot of also pesticides to clear everything. And you see a lot of erosion bringing fine sediments into the rivers. And that is one of the problems with hydromorphology. But it's not only with the olive trees. The European Environmental Agency has reviewed the river basin management plans from the European countries, and it showed that 40% of all rivers are affected by hydromorphology, and that is caused by hydropower, navigation, agriculture, flood protection, or urban development. We cannot undo these things. In fact, there's other regulations like renewable energy and sustainable transport. So there are other regulations, even by the European Commission, advocating to improve or enlarge these things. So we have to look for a balance between the ecological status of water and those things. So water quality, they ask to improve that to a good status, but with hydromorphology, it can be a compromise, it can be a balance with the functions. Okay, the other side of the story is, so we have a lot of regulated rivers with consequences for ecology. The other side of the story is that in particular LIFE programs and INTERREG programs from the European Commission are financing numerous projects to improve the quality of rivers and streams. And the beauty of Europe is that we have many languages, but that's also a bit of a problem in Europe, how to share those. If you see those projects, like a LIFE project in Austria, it will have a German documentation. A LIFE project in Sweden will have Swedish documentation, only to a limited extent in English. So how to share the expertise that we gain from these projects. So those two aspects are, in fact, the main driver for the reform project. And the reform project, here are the key people of the project, and you will have quite several of these people here today that will give you a lecture about the project. It's a project with 26 partners from 15 European countries, so we can use expertise coming from Finland up to Spain and from the UK up to Romania, with small stream, with large rivers, and bring that expertise together. It are not only research institutes, we also have a number of water management institutes who are helping us to formulate things that they can be applied for water management. So these are the objectives of the reform project, and the presentations you will hear in the course of today give you parts of this project. In the end, the Commission asks not to do only research and prepare scientific publications out of the research, but to transform the research into things that can be used by water management. And the two key aspects for this project are better indicators for cost-effective monitoring to assess the impact of hydromorphological degradation, and you will get presentations on that, to improve the tools and guidelines for restorations. On purpose, there's not the word develop, because there are numerous tools already available, so we try to see what is there already and to move forward. So this is then the scientific basis that is used to prepare that application. A request was also not to go into the field and collect new data, and they asked on purpose to see what is already out there in terms of information and review that. To develop a process-based hydromorphological framework, the observation was that hydromorphology is addressed in a too static way. And that is not the reality. In fact, it are the hydromorphological processes that create habitats and therefore form the basis for a large biodiversity. Another aspect is that if you look at regulated rivers, it's not only regulation, it's also all, there's also could be toxic substances, there can be nutrient problems. So how to disentangle what are the causes for the degradation you see in the streams. The fourth aspect is that water managers ask, how much do I need to restore my river? Is 5% enough? Do I need to restore 20%? And so we had some field work, looking at new places to see whether we could say whether the scale of restoration is important. And the final one is risk and benefit analysis. Both on the cost side and on the benefit side, restoration comes with uncertainty. So what can we offer in that respect? And we hope that together this work, and by putting it on our website, by putting the information in the wiki of the project, that there will be more appreciation for the benefits of restoration, and not only that the people have the feeling that it costs a lot of money. Okay. These are a few words about the context in which the project is taking place and the context in which the summer school is organized for you. And the idea is for today that in a number of lectures we give you step by step much more insight into results or the project or approaches that are very much connected to the project itself. The final slide here is that we do not only work by ourselves, but we try to interact with other groups outside the project. An important one is the European Center for River Restoration. That is the largest community of people exchanging experiences on restoration. And from the formal point of view, that we are in close contact with working groups that implement the Water Framework Directive, and that they can use our results. And for that, towards the end of the project, we will have another workshop to communicate the results of reform to the member states in particular. Okay. That is a bit about the opening, and then Ian, would you like to